The burst of speed, a head fake, moves it across. DeKeyser scores!
Hey, Red Wings fans, welcome to Coffee with Carley. I'm sitting down today with number 65 defenseman Danny DeKeyser, Michigan native. How is it to play for your home team?
It's awesome. I mean, it's really exciting for me because I grew up here. I grew up watching the team here. You know, any kid growing up in Detroit area would be a huge Red Wings fan. And, you know, my family's all here and they get to come to the games and stuff like that. So it's fun.
But I know you played for Little Caesars when you were younger, which is really cool.
Yeah.
They're here at Belfour practice facility.
Yep.
But how did you get into it?
It was definitely my dad. He got me started in it. Just in the wintertime, there was like this pond by our house where we used to live. And but he definitely pushed me to play hockey. I'm definitely glad he did. He's always like my biggest supporter.
Speaking of family, you have a beautiful wife and a beautiful little girl, McKinley. What's it like being a dad? How do you juggle that, being a professional athlete and being on the road all the time?
It gets tough sometimes. I mean, you know, we have long road trips. We're out west for 10 days or 12 days or whatever, and it's a long time to be away from your family. I know my wife loves when she is able to bring her down to the games and stuff like that because they have a good time together. You know, things definitely change, but it's all for the good. And you know, I wouldn't really want it any other way.
Michigan summers, I mean, now you still have them being your off season, but what did you do growing up?
Actually, I played a lot of street hockey. So the neighborhood I grew up in, there was a lot of kids my age and a little bit older. So like it seemed like every night of the week, probably in the summer, we were out there playing street hockey. We would set up two nets and, you know, whoever wanted to come out and play. And I think that probably helped my hockey career too. It was a lot of fun.
You went to Worcester and Michigan University. You just got your degree recently.
I started, you know, taking classes again probably 2.5 years ago. Mm-hmm. I played 3 years at Western, and you know, obviously I didn't finish there. So it was when I left college and signed here, it was one of the things on my list that I wanted to finish up. It was definitely tough. I tried to get a lot of my work done on the road and during road trips and stuff like that.
Going back to Kalamazoo to graduate, what was the day like?
It was just a nice morning in Kalamazoo. I remember pulling up to campus, and it was just a really nice day, and you know, my family was there, so walking across the stage was awesome. It gave me a good feeling of accomplishment, and then had some lunch afterwards with the family and came on back home, so it was good.
Congratulations. I mean, that's a huge accomplishment.
Thank you.
So being a Red Wings fan growing up, did you have a favorite player?
My biggest player growing up that I liked to watch was Nick Lidstrom. He was so smooth out there on the ice, and he just never made any mistakes, and he made the game look so easy. I mean, he was just a pleasure to watch.
Born and raised in Michigan, we're gonna play a game. How Michigan are you? So there's some of these things that, you know, only Michiganers say or do or would know. So, all right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Point where your home is on your hand.
Right here. Approximately.
All right, pop or soda?
Pop.
Pop?
Yeah.
Do you remember your coldest Halloween as a kid? Did you have to wear a jacket over your costume?
Yeah, I think I might've been like Batman or something like that. And it seems like a lot of years you have to wear a jacket over your costume, but this one was particularly bad. I had like a full winter coat on, and I don't think you could see my costume at all, except for my mask.
Superman or Blue Moon ice cream?
Ooh, I think Superman.
Superman?
Yeah, because I always got that as a kid. I thought that was, you know, the different colors, I thought it was the coolest thing.
What is the acceptable temperature to start wearing shorts?
I would say at least anything like above 60.
Above 60?
Yeah.
Do you cut your own Christmas tree or do you have a synthetic one?
Recently, I've had a synthetic one, but yeah, it's just easier. But when I was growing up, we used to cut them quite a bit.
Did you learn how to drive a boat before you learned how to drive a car?
I did, yeah.
How old were you?
I was probably like 14 or 15, somewhere in that. I think like the age that you're allowed to be on a jet ski by yourself in Michigan is 14, or at least it used to be when I was younger. Mm-hmm. So I was always like pumped about that. Like my 14th birthday, I could ride a jet ski by myself. So that
it's
was always
a
exciting.
Michigander thing.
I know, yeah.
Well, that's all we have. Danny, thank you so much for sitting down with me and having some coffee.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks a lot for having me. I appreciate it.
Cheers.
Cheers.